So, my dear students, as we have seen the merits, every coin is having its two sides. In sole trader business, we are having some demerits also. The very first is limited capital. In sole tradership business, the financial resources are limited. Because a sole trader is having limited funds, he is not having adequate capital to start large scale operation. For big business deal, he is not having resources. So this is the demerit of sole tradership. Lack of specialization. A sole trader is having limited ability. He is not having ability to manage sales, purchase, marketing, distribution of goods. So many work is there. So one person cannot be an expert in each and every function of the business. So he may commit some errors of judgment, which can create a loss. So he have to hire some professional experts, but he cannot afford such expense. It is also one of the demerit. Now we go to unlimited liability. He is personally liable for all the losses of the business. So he is always very cautious and conservative in taking his decision. Uncertain life. Sole trader does not enjoy continuity of existence. Suppose if he falls sick, if he became insolvent due to death of the proprietor, the business can be stopped. His successor may not be capable enough to carry on business successfully. So in that case, the business is having a certain life. Limited scope for expansion. So it is one of the big demerit of sole trader that he is having limited scope of expansion, as his resources, his capital is limited. He cannot expand his business to large size. His goodwill is also low. So that is the negative part of a sole trader. Thank you. Please do write and learn it. God bless you all, my dears.